Welcome to our tutorial series for ARP from Midicake. If you've not seen the earlier videos in this series, I'd recommend watching them first. In this video, we'll see how to access ARP's parameters and how to change them to build sequences. As we've already seen, ARP has two main modes: play mode for performing and set mode for editing parameters. Press the set button to toggle between play and set modes. When in set mode, the LEDs will light up blue and the display will show ARP settings. The different parameters are accessed via the chord and note buttons and are labelled beneath each button. Pressing a button will select that parameter and its name and value will be shown in the display. You can change the value using the up and down buttons, or by rotating the tempo control. You can change parameters while ARP is playing. Parameters have different ranges of values, therefore ARP's tempo control will make small changes when rotated slowly and large changes when rotated quickly. The up and down buttons can also be held to scroll quickly through values. Changes made to parameter values will be saved automatically. Some buttons have more than one parameter option. The display shows how many options are available for the selected parameter. There is a list graphic on the left-hand side. Press the parameter button repeatedly to scroll through the parameter options. You can also press and hold the parameter button, then press up or down to move through the options list. ARP has four arpeggiators. You can select which arpeggiator sequence you are editing by pressing the select buttons labelled 1, 2, 3 and 4. Any changes to parameter values will only affect the selected arpeggiator. However, you can also double press one of the select buttons to select all four arpeggiators. Then, any value changes will be applied to all four sequences. You can easily copy sequences between the arpeggiator channels. This can be useful for creating variations, or as a starting point for another ARP sequence. Select the ARP channel to copy. Press the copy button, then select the ARP to copy to. ARP generates MIDI data, and each arpeggiator channel can be set to output to a specific MIDI channel. Select the MIDI out parameter and set the output channel. All ARPs can output on the same channel or on different channels. ARP is polyphonic, meaning that it outputs multiple notes simultaneously on the same MIDI channel. If you are using a mono synthesizer, which only has a single voice, its behavior can be unpredictable when receiving polyphonic note data. You can fix this by setting the ARP channel to mono voice mode. Press the MIDI button again to select voice mode and change the value. This forces ARP to send only one note at a time. Although specific to the selected ARP channel, any other ARPs on the same MIDI channel will also operate in mono mode, even if they are set to poly. Before we finish, we'll just mention global settings. These affect numerous aspects of ARP's behavior and are not specific to a single arpeggiator. Press the menu button and the display will show Global Menu. There are many options in this list and they affect things like MIDI Control, MIDI Through, MIDI Note Sync and Live Play options, MIDI Program and Control Change channels, MIDI Output options, Stop Button Behavior and LED Brightness. There's more information on these and all ARP's parameters in the user manual, available to download from midicake.com. That's it for this video. In the next, we'll look at each of the main sequence shaping parameters in a bit more detail. Please hit like if you found this video helpful, and perhaps subscribe, as it helps us continue to make videos like this one. If you have any views or questions, please feel free to comment below or message us via midicake.com. See you in the next one. Cheers.